welcome everyone to our Inside Mondelez Careers event. My name is Lina and I work in our Northern Europe talent acquisition team, partnering with our marketing and corporate functions. I hope you're all ready to come into a journey with us today and explore what it's really like to work at Mondelez International. And today we will discuss our culture, career paths, and you will have the chance to hear from some of our employees within our sales and marketing function that are currently on our early careers program and those who have now progressed their careers further with the business following the completion of their program. And to clarify with you what we mean with early careers, this refers to our internships, graduate opportunities, and apprenticeship programs. So Mondelez International empowers people to snag right in over 150 countries around the world. This is us, and we are leading the future of snacking with iconic global and local brands such as Oreo, Belvita, and Lou Biscuits, Cadbury Dairy Milk, Milka, and Toblerone Chocolate. And these are just a few of our big brands that we own. And we are one of the largest snack companies in the world with global net revenue of $27 billion US dollars in 2020. And we make and sell primarily snacks, including biscuits, chocolate, gum, and candy, as well as various cheese and grocery products. And with the introduction out of the way, let's go and get to know our panel of employees who are with us today. So over to you, Roy. Would you like to go ahead and introduce yourself?
Thanks, Nina. I'm Roy. I joined the business just under 7 years ago via our apprenticeship program, where I completed a series of placements across the Mondelez sales function, as well as studying for a business management degree at Aston University at the same time. In terms of my current role, I'm currently working as a customer cat dev manager on the standard confectionery category, leading the category relationship with one of our largest grocery customers. I'm actually based at home at the moment, but I was in Uxbridge prior to the pandemic.
Great, thank you, Roy. And then, Natalie, would you like to go ahead and introduce yourself as well?
Yeah, definitely. So hi, everyone. My name is Natalie Dragic, and I am currently a senior brand manager for the Dairylea brand here in the UK. And this means that I have full commercial and marketing responsibility for Dairylea. Like a lot of you, hopefully, joined Mondelez on the early careers graduate scheme, where I did a number of sales and marketing placements before I realized my complete love for marketing. And since then, it's been a journey. So over the past 7 years, I've worked on the Philadelphia brand. I've also worked in Malaysia and Singapore on Oreo brands and some local Malaysian and Singaporean brands there. And now finally, I'm here in the UK in our Uxbridge office on Dairylea.
Fantastic. Thank you, Natalie. And Pratham, can you please introduce yourself as well?
Sure. Hey, everyone. My name is Pratham and I joined Mondelez back in June 2020 on the early career scheme as a sales intern. So currently still at uni at the moment, as doing this as part of my placement year, and I study at Loughborough University. And to put it into context, you know, I work in the category development team in biscuits. And so we're responsible ultimately for leading and influencing and driving biscuits thinking, basically, and bringing the outside in order to unlock future growth opportunities for the business and the category. My role includes things such as conducting competitor and market analyses, tracking and forecasting new product developments, and identifying opportunities to win. And I also manage three exciting brands from a cat dev perspective, and those are Barney, Mikado, and Prince.
Very interesting. Thank you, Pratham. And last but not least, Laura, can you please also tell a bit more about yourself?
Sure. Thanks, Nina. And hi, everybody. A pleasure to be here speaking to you today. So my name is Laura Gray. I joined Mondelez back in 2012 on the commercial graduate scheme. Since then, I've done a variety of roles in both sales and marketing across various different brands and customers. At the moment, I am a senior brand manager for Christmas, and I look after the chocolate business across Europe, so both brand equity, innovation, and a strategy role. So a great stretch role for me personally, and it's great to be sort of flexing into the European nature of our business, having spent before that time in UK marketing roles on Cadbury Dairy Milk and Green and Blacks.
Fantastic. Thank you, Laura. And yeah, now we got to know our panel a bit better. We will dive into the questions that will help you to get to know Mondelez International a bit better today. So yeah, first and foremost, I'd be really interested to hear a bit more about, you know, what a sales function does within Mondelez International. Maybe Roy, can you tell us a bit of a brief summary on this?
Yes, sure. So the Mondelez sales function is quite broad, but top line, it delivers £2 billion worth of revenue, works across categories such as chocolate, candy, biscuits and cheese. And there's brands that you may know within that, such as Cadbury, Oreo, Maynard's Bassett's and Philadelphia. So some really big household brands there, which you're definitely able to talk to friends and family about. The sales function itself consists of four key domains. So the first one is key accounts. They work directly with our customers to drive sales. So anything that you see in store, whether that be a Tesco, whether that be your convenience store, we have a team that work with those retailers to drive those sales and work with them to partner on how they work together. Sales revenue planning are our second function. They own the commercial plan. And they help enable our sales team to deliver our brand plans. So they're almost like the background behind the wheels within our business. Field sales are our third function. This is quite a broad function. So they partner with our retailers across the UK to support and advise them. That's around 150 people who are out across the regions across the UK. And also finally, where I currently work, category development and activation, who help to kind of bring our plans to life in store for our shoppers, as well as identifying ways to drive overall category performance for both our customers and Mondelez.
Fantastic. Very interesting to hear that about our sales function. Thank you, Roy. And then I'd be also really keen to hear more about our marketing function. Laura, could you maybe tell us more about what our marketing function does here at Mondelez?
Yeah, of course. So I think the essence of it is bringing to life the delicious products that we make for consumers. So I think every day there's great variety, whether it be working with Insights colleagues to put, you know, the people and the brands at the heart of everything we do. And I think the marketing's role is really connecting. So it's connecting people, it's connecting different teams, both within our organisation and externally with our agencies, but really connecting them to the people that eat and enjoy our products as part of their lives. So I think we have a framing that we call humaning, which is about kind of creating real human connections. And I think this approach, it really means that we kind of move away from what can be quite data-led tactics, just a place where we kind of scratch the surface, go a little bit deeper, really understanding people, what makes people tick, and therefore how can we, you know, make sure that they're really connecting with our brands, but also that we're doing what's right for the people that enjoy those brands. So I think one of the big things about marketing is no day is the same. So one day you can be briefing a new TV advert, the next you can be in a consumer workshop about an exciting new product, and then, you know, the following week standing on a factory line watching something be literally produced. And so for me, you know, the variety is just brilliant within marketing. And also within marketing, we have a great balance. So a really nice commercial lens in partnership with functions like sales and Roy and his teams. But also we have a big, what we call equity lens. So this is really about understanding the brands, what makes our brands tick, and how we can bring those brand stories to life for people.
Very interesting. Sounds very exciting as well. Thank you, Laura. Great. And so you all joined on an early career scheme, and could you maybe tell me what attracted you to join Mondelez when you first applied and went for the opportunity with us? And maybe, Pratham, you joined us last year as an intern. Could you tell us about why did you apply for the role and what attracted you to Mondelez?
Yeah, so I think for me, it formed the third year of my university experience. You know, getting a job out in the real world is something that many people are daunted to do, but definitely, you know, wanting that experience. So I guess that was the initial push for me to apply to companies like Mondelez. But I guess, you know, what attracted me to join Mondelez in particular, I guess there were lots of different reasons, actually. But I guess the one that's most relevant for me is actually the emphasis that the company places on employee development. So, you know, throughout my time in the company thus far, I actually think that Mondelez encourages employees to really own their development for themselves, as opposed to, you know, putting out kind of on paper, you know, what the steps required are and, you know, a fixed kind of path. I think it really embraces the fact that, you know, no career path is the same in the company and for everyone. So I think that's what really attracted me to the company, knowing that I could, you know, shape my experience. And I guess I knew that I wanted to learn and grow as much as I could throughout this year. And, you know, I certainly looked back to the start of the year and I was kind of saying, well, you know, a year seems like quite a lot of time, but I'm sitting now just over 13 months in and I'm kind of asking where the time has gone. And I guess throughout the year, you know, I've been wanting to try and get comfortable with moving out of my comfort zone, which is something that, you know, I haven't always been able to do. But I can only do that with challenge. And I guess, you know, with the support of my peers and the company itself, I've been really able to achieve things that I never thought I would have before, you know, even exploring the opportunity at all. And I guess one thing that's really useful is that all employees go through performance review processes, and that gives them an opportunity to track and reflect, you know, what their performance is like, what they've achieved, but also tailor plans to what their future ambitions and goals are for the future. So I think development is such a massive part of the business, and I think it's absolutely invaluable to my experience.
Great. Thank you, Prathan. That's really good to hear. And yeah, Natalie, you joined us some time ago back in the day as a graduate on one of our graduate schemes. Could you tell me more about, yeah, what attracted you to join Mondelez?
Yeah, definitely. And I have to say, only 7 years ago. I don't want to seem too old for this. But I think, and it was great to hear your reflections. I think for me, there were probably three key reasons. The first one was just the incredible brands. So I, like many people, grew up with brands like Cadbury, Oreo, Maynards, and being able to work in a role with brands that you love and being able to make such a tangible impact compared to other roles that were out there at the time that I was applying was just such a huge appeal. I think the second one was, and I'll be fully honest about this, I was quite lost when I was applying for jobs in my final year of university, and I actually didn't know what I wanted to do. So applying for a graduate scheme that really promoted that and allowed you to focus on both sales and marketing and was very open about the fact that, you know, you might love something here, you might not, but actually it's a great chance for you to rotate across 3 years and really find out where that sweet spot is for you. That really appealed to me because, I mean, I never knew what marketing was before I joined the Early Careers Graduate Scheme. And thank God I had it because it's the most exciting function, obviously, in my biased opinion, hence why I'm still in it. But I loved that. And then the final one for me was the opportunity for international moves. So I think a lot of people are surprised when you hear that Mondelez has 80,000 employees. I think it's across over 80 countries. And I had studied Chinese at university, and I always had the ambition of moving with my work to Asia at some point. And Mondelez, from very early doors, really spoke openly about international moves. And it was something that I've been lucky that I've been able to do in my career and in my time here.
Really good. Thank you, Natalie. That's really good to hear. Great. And yeah, moving on, I would also really like to hear from you if you could share a bit more about our culture at Mondelez. Perhaps, yeah, Prathan, would you like to share this with us?
Yeah, so I think for me, again, it just forms part of another reason as to why I actually joined Mondelez itself. I think the culture is such a big thing. And I knew that, you know, in previous years of my life, I wasn't the most outgoing person. And I knew that if I was going to go into something like business and especially sales, I needed to kind of bring myself out of my shell, if you like. So I knew that, you know, the very people-centric culture that I believe Mondelez possesses and enforces, well, maybe not enforces, but, you know, really encourages, is something that I'm really proud of. And I think, you know, we can all be proud of sitting here now and say that actually, you know, people are so central to the success of this company. Obviously, without the people, you know, we're not a business. And ultimately, I think that's what I really enjoy about this culture is the people. The people do make it everything.
Lovely. And Natalie, you just touched on, you know, your international move, and that's quite interesting. And obviously, it really shows that our culture is encouraging our employees to, you know, step outside the comfortable and really take up an opportunity. Would you like to share more about that?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think what's really interesting with culture is now that I've worked across multiple functions, multiple brands and multiple markets, it's amazing how true the culture is to everywhere you go with Mondelez. And I think if I had to pick a few themes that I just see everywhere, one is this really collaborative and supportive nature of everyone, whether that's a manager or your colleague. And with that in mind, you know, people development is really at the heart of everything. And, you know, you touched on my international moves, but that's only possible because, you know, I shared my desire and I shared my ambitions, but then I had a huge network of people and of brilliant managers, colleagues across multiple markets that all just wanted to help make that happen and wanted to really help coach and guide me to that. So that one, and you see everywhere across everything. I think there's also, and Pratham, you touched on a bit earlier, but there's such an opportunity to make a huge impact in every role that you have. And when I was on the graduate scheme, one of the things that really surprised me early on is how much autonomy and trust you're given. So you start on day one and you're obviously with enough guidance, it's not, you know, scary, but you're given these incredible projects and innovations. You're just trusted to fly with it. And you see that across every role. I mean, at least I've seen across every role that I've been on. And for me, there's just such an exciting and fast-paced nature of FMCG, which is what we call our industry, in that, you know, products change often, consumer habits change, obviously with COVID, behaviors change. And it's really exciting to constantly be stretched and challenged and, you know, having to think about that, especially in marketing, which I love. And it's really obviously encouraged across the entire business and every function.
Yeah, great. Thank you, Natalie. And Laura, I know you worked in a regional role during your career so far at Mondelez, and I assume working with different markets would have also exposed you to different, kind of cultures. I mean, how was Definitely. That for you? Can you share a bit more about that?
Yeah, no, I think I'd just echo what the guys have said. I think the only build I'd have is that genuinely every day at work, I have a laugh. And I think that's quite unique. Like, I have genuine friends at work. We're all very busy. We all work on really hugely exciting projects. But I think that element of trust that Natalie touched on just means that you do build those genuine friendships that then mean that, you know, it's just fun. It's a fun place to be. And I think that really helps me personally have that kind of get out of bed feeling each morning and just kind of come to it being a really great place to work. So I think, yes, there are those broad themes that kind of unite everything together. But I have seen that across all the multiple different European markets across my role. But, you know, predominantly my career has been based in the UK, but it definitely stretches throughout Europe as well.
Fantastic. So good to hear. Great, thanks. And now, I mean, we have all been working from home during the past, 18 months? It's been a long time, but what I'd really like to hear is what it's like working in a Mondelez office. Maybe Roy, could you tell us what it's like to be in an office at Mondelez?
Yeah, so I had to cast my mind back for this because it's obviously been 16 months of working from home. It's almost the new normal, I think, is working from home. So kind of looking forward to going back into the office and actually seeing people face to face, because that was a big part of going into the office versus Teams like we are today. In terms of the office that I'm based in, I'm currently based within Uxbridge. That's our sort of commercial head office. So where most of our marketing, most of our sales teams will sit. It's recently undergone a renovation. So it's quite nice and modern. It's quite a fast paced environment, as kind of the guys have mentioned before, but also quite fun as well. So there's, in terms of like the office itself, it's laid out with a mix of spaces to collaborate and meet with other colleagues, as well as sort of individual workspaces, but it's got a very open feel to it. And people don't have their own desk. Like, you can sit wherever you want every day. So it's not like you have a name on your desk. You will mix and you'll meet other people throughout the day who work in different functions, who you don't necessarily talk to all the time, which is really positive, I think. And then there's some other nice perks. So you get free coffee, there's a staff shop, and that's kind of a big one. So you see some big queues at lunchtime where people are picking up some of their favorite products to take back to their friends and family. So yeah, it's a positive experience. And yeah, looking forward to sort of going back into the office when it allows us to.
Yeah, I bet. Yeah, no. Thank you for sharing that, Roy. It's really good to hear what it's like in our Oxford office. And what I would also like to hear from you now, considering that you all moved us, joined us on an early careers scheme, I would really like to hear what are the benefits of joining one of those programs, and can you tell me what career opportunities can look like after the scheme? That would be really good to hear. Maybe Laura, would you be able to share a bit more about yourself?
Yeah, of course. I think the theme of early careers at Mondelez is probably empowerment. So we're all encouraged to really own our own careers. As Natalie touched on earlier, there's a great support network that sits underneath that. But really, you know, deciding where do you want to go? What makes you tick? What excites you? But also, where do you need to learn? Where do you need to feel a bit uncomfortable? And where can you kind of grow through that process? So for me, post the graduate scheme, this meant staying in sales for a role. I always knew that my home function would be marketing, but I really wanted to hone my kind of commercial acumen skills. And that meant for me landing some trade terms with two of our biggest customers, which I was able to do, and kind of write some joint business plans as part of that kind of off-scheme transition that I then came back ultimately into marketing. Mm. And I think doing that through sort of connecting with mentors, being a mentee myself, and just generally having a really great network of people and a great soundboard, I think is something that is really priceless in early careers. You know, the network is massive. We have buddy systems, we have mentor systems. You know, Natty and I will often just connect and have a catch up together. You know, we sort of went through the scheme at similar times. And I think latterly I've been involved with the scheme, I guess, from the other side, from a bit more of a planning side, kind of working on the early careers talent forum. And I think that forum is really set up to help plan, help support, but help ignite critically the talent in our early careers programs. And I think that just creates a really rounded experience from hopefully what everyone's watching today coming in and thinking about us as a talent forum and a kind of like a community to become involved with through being really active in that community. But then also I think a big part of it is that kind of paying back to the community once you then roll off the scheme. And sort of having that just really great networking, connecting with everyone. But Natalie, don't know if you've got anything else to add to that.
No, I love it. I was smiling the whole way through because I completely agree. I think for me, I mean, the benefits are huge. I mean, I touched on it before, so I won't go into it too much again, but I didn't know what I wanted to do, but the graduate scheme really sets you up with the right mentors, the right support network, and the right teams to, one, help you understand, you know, what it is you want to do. And actually, some people, you know, they're happy to always jump between functions, but if you have a particular passion and love for a function, it really helps you to hone into that. And also, to Laura's point, if there are areas that, you know, are great for you to develop on, it really sets you up for that. And I think if I reflect on my experience, the fact that I had the opportunity to really go into a key retailer in my sales role has meant that I am so much more commercially rounded than if I just realized that I wanted to do marketing straight off the bat and then went into it. And I'm so grateful for that. And as a result of that, and as a result of the brilliant community and the brilliant support network that I have that really focus on my development, I've been able to very quickly progress through being a brand manager to a junior brand manager to a brand manager, and now a senior brand manager. And as I mentioned earlier, being able to have that support to move to Southeast Asia has been incredible. And I have to say it was all because of those initial years where I was given that breadth and that chance to just grow and understand the business, where, you know, you might not get that if you just joined in a specific function straight away.
Mm. Yeah, very interesting. Thank you for sharing that, Laura and Natalie. And yeah, I can hear that both of you have had really great opportunities and your career paths look so exciting. I mean, could you tell me maybe what your biggest career highlight has been so far at Mondelez?
Yeah, I'm happy to jump in there. I think for me, my proudest moment was when when I was in Malaysia and Singapore, I was able to make Oreo the fastest growing brand in the country, which was incredible. And that is, again, through the trust that the business gave me to lead white space seasonal initiatives on the brand. One was for Hari Raya baking that we did on Oreo, and the other one was through launching a very new innovative flavor for Chinese New Year, which was very exciting.
That's awesome. Really, I don't quite know how I'm going to follow that. I think mine would be a campaign I did for Cadbury Dairy Milk, all around connecting generations. So at the heart of Cadbury brand is generosity and being a brand that brings people together. And we did a campaign called Donate Your Words, where we took the Cadbury logo bar, the glass and a half, off of the front of pack. We did a whole kind of connected pack and activation and TV adverts and social media in partnership with Age UK, where we sought to combat the issue of loneliness within older people and older societies and just connect everybody together. And it got an awesome reaction, and I certainly kind of behave in a different way because of that now than I did. My husband's always telling me to stop chatting to kind of elderly people at bus stops and things, but yeah, that one really, really touched me. So yeah, that's probably mine.
Yeah, I really love that campaign, Laura. It's so good.
Oh, thanks guys.
Oh yeah, great, thank you. And yeah, Pratham, can you maybe tell us what your highlight has been so far at Mondelez during the last year?
Yeah, so it's interesting because, you know, I came into the company, you know, obviously really motivated, but ultimately I was kind of questioning in my mind as to, you know, what was achievable from my perspective, you know, coming in as an intern, you know, realistically, you know, what are the big projects that I'm going to be working on? But actually, I think the most notable achievement and highlight that I've had is actually working on seasonal biscuits. It's something that, you know, previously within category, we haven't put too much focus into for lots of different reasons. However, alongside me and my manager, we were very confident in, you know, making a stand for biscuits this year. And so with that, we created a little bit of history within the category team and the category in general, I suppose, with, you know, by creating the first ever biscuit seasonal tracker, which is something that we haven't previously been able to do. And obviously, you know, all of us here know the importance of looking at performance and what that means and what insights we can draw from that to make us even bigger and better for the future. So I think to be able to put that across was absolutely amazing, working with the likes of Samit, so sales analytics, marketing insights team, did a great job with giving us the help that we need around data and whatnot and us kind of piecing that together. Mm. And I guess that opened up the door for the first ever entry of biscuits into to the winter show, which was a great achievement as well, not just to have that data there, but actually physical presence representing the category and being able to present all the great work that we've been doing and plan to do in the future as well. I think that was definitely the highlight of my year.
That sounds fantastic. Thank you. Sounds like you all had such great highlights during your careers. Really great to hear. Thank you. That brings us to the end of our Inside Mondelez International event. So we hope that you have all found this session insightful and getting to know us better as a company. Our recruitment for our 2022 early careers programs for commercial areas now open for applications. And if you're interested, we recommend you to apply early via our careers website. And yeah, I would also like to invite you to follow us on our social media channels, such as LinkedIn and Instagram, to stay up to date with what we're up to here at Mondelez. And yeah, hope that we inspired you to make it happen. And I would like to thank you for taking part. And yeah, take care. Bye-bye.
Thanks, everyone. Bye.
Thanks, everyone. Thank you. Bye.